This is a working example to help you for lab number 5. The last lab number 4, we dealt with inflow performance relationship. That is, we constructed a curve that relates the bottom hole pressure to the flow rate, inflow rate. So in this lab, we're going to look at the outflow. That's from the bottom hole to the surface, the flow of the gas from the bottom hole to the surface. So we're going to be constructing also the bottom hole pressure versus the outflow rate. We learned that there are 3 templates we can use for that. There are two particular scenarios we're going to consider. We're going to assume only a single phase is flowing, that is only a gas is flowing from the bottom hole to the surface. Then the second assumption is that 4 phases are flowing at the same time. So the gas, the water, condensate, and sand, they are all flowing together with the sand. So that's the second part. I'm going to construct the TPR, the tubing performance relationship curve, considering a single phase flow. I'm also going to construct for 4 phase flow. For single phase flow, we learned 2 methods, 2 templates. I can either use the average TZ template or Colander-Smith template. They both give you the same result, so I'm just going to use one of them. I prefer to use average TZ because you give the flow rate in mega standard cubic feet per day, and that's, we're going to be plotting our curve in mega standard cubic feet per day, so it's more practical. So we're going to be using the average TZ if we want to construct. You can always check for any particular flow rate, check if the calculated bottom hole pressure is the same. Cross-check with other template. So let's first do the first one. If you are constructing the template, remember for TPR, outflow, you have to supply the flow rate and the template will calculate the bottom hole pressure. So let's do the first one. Yeah, these are the given data for this exercise. The specific gravity. Now we need the inside diameter of the pipe, which is given. That's what you need. Then we need the reservoir, the wellhead pressure, and the wellhead temperature. We need the bottom hole temperature. We're going to calculate the bottom hole pressure anyway. Then we need to know the roughness of the pipe and the length of the pipe, which is the total depth of the wellbore. That is given here as what? The length of the pipe, 10,000 feet. That's the depth of the wellbore. So now I'm going to open the average TZ template and enter all this information there. The Colander-Smith template is also the same thing. Now let me make a remark here. You know, when we were constructing the IPR, the last lab number 4, we only consider a single phase flowing. That is, the reservoir is delivering only the gas to the bottom hole. We are not considering whether the reservoir is delivering sand or water. We only consider the gas. So the IPR is for a single phase flow. Now the TPR, we're going to do single phase, then we're going to do 4 phase. So let's do the single phase first. So I click on the average TZ. So I'm going to download that. I click on that to download. Let me open it here. Average TZ. Now let's look at the data. The Colander-Smith template is exactly the same input you need. The only difference now, you need to watch out for the side, the unit. See, for this template, your flow rate must be in mega standard cubic feet per day. So now I want to construct the TPR from 1 mm, which is 1 million, to 10 million. And I've been given to use interval of 1 million. So I'm going to do 0. I'm going to always start with 0. Then the next one will be 1 million. The next one will be 2 million until I get to 10 million. So I'm going to do 11. 0, 1, 2, up to, okay. So now let's, as we did for IPR, I'm going to run the first one. 0. I put 0 there. So the red is the one that you always vary. That's the flow rate. So now TPR is opposite the IPR. In IPR, you supply the bottom hole pressure, the template to calculate the flow rate. But for TPR, you supply the flow rate, the template will calculate the bottom hole pressure. So let's start with flow rate of 0. Now, the template can calculate the bottom hole pressure for flow rate of 0. Only for single phase. If I try, you will see when we're going to run the four phase, it's not going to calculate for 0. It always give an error. So now, once you do that, look at my data is given there. Specific gravity, 0.71. Inside diameter of the tube, the roughness, the length of the pipe, which is the depth of the well. Angle of inclination, vertical well is always 0. That's the well head pressure. Well, at temperature, bottom hole temperature. Then this is the one we're going to be changing to construct the flow rate, the TPR. So I'm going to do 0 first. Remember, you go to, they all use macro. View. Macro is the last one there. Okay, I have two things open, so I have the four face open, that's right. Okay, wrong macro. Now, I will advise you, let me close that. Don't always have two files with macros open at the same time. You might get confused to know which one you're running. So let me close the four face. Okay, so now, for 0, remember, this template will calculate for various depths, starting from the well head 0 depth, when the depth is 0, up to the bottom hole at 10,000. The bottom hole is at the last one, that's the 10,000 feet. Remember, because you put 10,000 as the depth. The mid depth is 5,000. This template will calculate the temperature at all those depths, the temperature, the pressure, and the compressibility factor. But what we need to construct the template is only the pressure. So we only need the bottom hole pressure, which is the last one. That's one I highlight in yellow. So that's 0.1008. So I'm going to create, just as we did for IP, I'm going to create a table here, then I will transfer the data to my workbook later. So I'm going to do, always put Q on the left. So I do Q here. Then pressure here. Okay, so I'm going to be changing, I'm going to start with 0. The next one will be what? Now let, The next one should be 1 million. But 1 million, this is a mega. So it's going to be 1,000 of mega. So I'm going to do the next one will be 1,000. So I'm going to align the two. I'm going to copy until I get to 10 million, 10,000. See, the tip is showing you the number. Okay, that's it. So for zero, the pressure is what? 1008. So I move up, I change, the next one is 1,000. You know, 1,000 is 1 million because this is in mega. So 1,000. But that's what we are told to do. Do an interval of 1 million. But since this one is in mega, so 1,000 is also 1 million. So I'm going to run that macro run 1027. Now, your own value is going to be different because you are running, I'm giving you a different parameter. So, then the next one. Next one is what? 2,000. Oh, we've done 2,000. That's 1082. Let's see. We're going to give you 1082. Yep. We did. It's the same that I gave to you. If you read your notes, you see that we did for 2,000. 4,000. The important thing in this exercise is for you to fill in the data correctly. If you mess up this data, the input data, you'll be constructing the wrong thing. So that's 1404 there. I think everybody did correctly the last lab, so I expect the same thing here. 6,000. Now, when you are changing the numbers, make sure your mouse is. What happened? Okay, slide. Sorry, 1544. We're almost there. Now you have to, once you change a number, you have to make sure your mouse is not over it, because otherwise, if it's not entered, it will be running the last data. So you have to lift your mouse off the, why is this thing shifting? 1693. I think I know why. So the next one is 8,000. Oh. 2010. Please don't copy my data, just do your own. Your own input data is different. So the last one now, 10,000. So don't forget, don't plot any graph in the template. Somebody still sent me the template. I don't want you to send me the template. You have to open your own workbook. Okay. I'm going to copy the data and open a workbook. And in the next video, I will show you how to collect data for the four-phase flow. So now, you know how to open it. I'm going to, okay, let me copy first. So I open a new textbook, a new workbook, new. I'm going to paste my data there. Okay, the next video, okay, let me do this. I'm going to write here, I'm going to write single phase. The next video, I'll show you how to do the four phase.